This is Rishikesh from Chemical Engineering second year.
This is Vishnu from Chemical Engineering V90.
So we are demonstrating the effect and application of Venturi effect in aerators. So we have a T-joint here. The pipe coming in here is a flow for water. This is pipe for inlet for air. And we have made a Venturi in this T-joint by applying some more pipes. And the outlet pipe will be consisting of aerated water. So my colleague Vishnu will now tell you how the actual effect will work.
So basically what we are doing is the water is entering through this inlet pipe, and at the end the output will be consisting of air bubbles. So we can use this in aquariums wherein we need to again and again oxygenate the water present in the fish tank so that the fish can live there. So now we will be demonstrating how to do that. And yeah, on the motor please. So as you can see, the bubbles are coming through here. So that is how the aeration works. Now if you close it. We'll be demonstrating it again once again. In that.
So as you can see now, the bubbles are coming. This is due to the Venturi effect. And if we are
closing
the bubbles, then the bubbles will stop. So that's the main point of Venturi effect. Yeah.
So and how the principle behind
bubble? Okay.
So the principle behind is that there's a difference in the area between inside this T-joint. Initially the area is constricted, and as soon as the area increases, when the area increases, there is a difference in pressure. That difference in pressure causes the vacuum formation, and as soon as the vacuum is formed, the air is sucked in. So that is the basic principle.
The applications of this machine is in aquariums. If we need a constant supply of fresh air in the aquarium for living of fishes, we can use this Venturi effect. The air will be sucked in through this pipe, and the water flow will continue to flow through this aquarium and this machine, so that the continuous flow of air is applicable.
This is also used in industrial uses, wherein a large scale model of this same thing is made, and steam is passed through instead of the fluid, and a hydrocarbon is sucked through, and so that is called steam eject reactor. And yeah,
thank you.